Hey guys, I'm here to review the movie A Demon Inside, also known as Spectre, I think, in wherever it was released. It stars Paz Vega from recently the OA, most notably from the movie Sex and Lucia, which is also really good. The OA is really cool. I don't know if you guys have ever seen that. Television show on Netflix. This movie is about a, kind of like a gypsy psychic tarot reader who meets a guy, he brutally rapes her, and then she becomes agoraphobic, which if you don't know what that means, it just means that somebody who is terrified to leave the house, go outside, refuses to leave. She locks herself up, she puts cameras everywhere. She becomes this total recluse who is paranoid about everyone and everything. And the film definitely plays on the, is this all in her mind? Is she making this up? Hence the demon inside. The title is a tad, it's not misleading, but I think just from a, this is a demon movie, or this is a possession movie, or this is this, the cover almost even looks like that. But no, it's her own demons inside, which I don't find as a spoiler at all, because that isn't really, anything. Now, getting into the good, which it's mostly good. I honestly keep notes when I watch these movies, and I have one single thing listed in the bad, and it's not even that bad. So for this kind of movie, which I would say this kind of movie, I'm not going to say it is like this movie because I don't want to give anyone a false indication of what this movie is, but it has a Martyrs feel to it. And what I mean by that is the main character is constantly having these flashes of some bloodied woman in her house that she sees and is terrified by it, just like the girl, the main girl in Martyrs. So it kind of has that feeling going on. But the movie is a lot more like something like, Repulsion, or more recently something like Eyes of the Mother, or Darling. Where the woman is just in her house by herself, basically watching her lose her mind. I guess if you're not into that kind of movie, if you didn't enjoy any of those kinds of movies, I wouldn't recommend this. But I don't know, I can't think off the top of my head a movie like that I haven't enjoyed. So clearly that kind of story works for me. It isn't a thrill a minute by any means. It's definitely a slow burn. The acting by everybody in the film is very, very good. Now, this film is in Spanish, so it's subtitled. It's currently on Netflix under the title The Demon Inside. So now the visuals are really good. I think that they pulled that off really well. There's an eeriness to them. They're super bloody and nightmarish. It's basically experiencing her nightmares. And I think it's very, very effective and efficient for what they're trying to convey. The atmosphere throughout the film is very solid and cohesive. It flows very well. I was never confused on what was going on outside of just the confusion that the film purposely wants you to have in the who, is this really her or is this her mind or what? Now, the film throws in a second, element, because in the house she's terrified of the attacker coming back and getting her again. But she also has this crazy neighbor. And that's done very, very well. I would think that secondary subplot of a almost second villain, a lot of films, get bogged down by too many villains. You see that in comic book movies where they try to throw too many villains in and it doesn't work most of the time. This actually worked. I mean, it just kind of heightened that, you know, agitation in her life and her mind and just kind of unsettled her more. So I thought that that was really good. And the second villain or whatever is really well and effective too. There's a cool little Shining homage. I mean, I can't imagine that that wasn't done on purpose. You'll have to see it to know what I'm talking about. But as soon as you see it, if you're a big Shining fan, you'll instantaneously know it. I can't imagine that it's not a Shining homage. But if it isn't, it isn't. The cinematography, the whole film just looks really good. I don't know what the budget was, but the production value looks really nice. Now, the bad. I mean, the only thing I have written down here for the bad is that the... And when I say the ending, I don't mean how it ends per se, but something about the ending is fairly telegraphed. Now, I might just be jaded because I've seen so many horror movies now. I've seen so many movies, thousands and thousands of them over the years, that I can just see these things coming from a mile away, and they really, really, really have to be clever for me to fall for them. But it was just something happens in the movie and you're like, oh, this is what's going to be later. And it's that happens with almost most movies that I watch. So it's something that I'm normally done. So I don't know if anyone else will like be that quick to be like, oh, that's what's whatever. So that's really it. I mean, that's really my only complaint. And that's so nitpicky. That's so little. That's so inane that it's hardly worth mentioning. But I try to throw something bad in unless the movie's absolutely perfect. Now, the movie in itself, I don't think a movie like this really... I mean, I guess a movie like this could be a 10 for 10. But because that it is this slow burn and because, you know, not a ton happens and whatnot, I'm not blown away by a film like this. So I try to save my 10 for 10s or anything like that. So even though I do think that it's almost a perfect film for what it was trying to accomplish, I didn't have the amount of excitement towards it to give it a 10. So saying that, I'd say it's about an 8.5 out of 10, just from, you know, what I expect from a film. But for the film that it was trying to be, I think they honestly achieved pretty much everything and it flowed really well. So for that kind of film, it's a 10 for 10. I mean, I couldn't really find anything wrong with it. Yeah, as I said, it's currently streaming on Netflix. If that's the kind of film that you're interested in, check it out. Pretty cool movie.